18 months between March 1965 and November 1966, 10 manned missions were launched from Cape Kennedy. 16 astronauts journeyed to their spacecraft on Launch Pad 19.
Fire for 10 second countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition.
Space is infinite. It yields slowly to exploration. In their voyages into this environment, the Gemini astronauts logged more than 1,940 man-hours of flight. Hurtling through space at 5 miles a second, they circled the Earth 600 times. In their 40 Earth days in space, they witnessed, as few men have, hundreds of sunsets on the changing horizons of our planet. For Gemini, equipment and techniques were developed that enabled astronauts for the first time to maneuver their spacecraft, to change their orbit, to accelerate to new heights. The first Gemini maneuvers were basic, flying formation with the spent second stage of the Titan II rocket.
Rev 4.
The first target for rendezvous was another manned spacecraft, Gemini 6. Approached within 1 foot of Gemini 7. Rendezvous, a major landmark in the history of manned flight. On 4 of the Gemini missions, the rendezvous target was the Agena space vehicle. During the program, the Gemini astronauts located and docked with the Agenas 9 times, developing experience and confidence in this important maneuver. But not everything always went according to plan. On Gemini 8, a thruster failed, causing excessive yaw and roll. Unable to find the source of trouble, command pilot Armstrong undocked. The roll rate accelerated, reaching an alarming 1 revolution per second. But Armstrong fought and won his struggle to regain control, and he brought Gemini 8 to a safe landing. On Gemini 9, when an Atlas rocket failed to place the Agena into orbit, a substitute docking target was launched. Trouble developed on the new target when its shroud failed to separate, leaving what the astronauts quickly named the Angry Alligator.
Gemini 9, Roy.
How are you?
I've got a weird-looking machine here.
Although flight experience was the primary objective of Gemini, the program offered a unique space laboratory to science, medicine, and technology. More than 50 experiments were carried on the Gemini spacecraft. Many were repeated on several flights. One experiment was photography of the Earth. Vast areas never seen by man in their entirety were studied. Hundreds of high-resolution photographs were made to provide new knowledge about the weather of the world. Perhaps the most spectacular experiment of the Gemini program was extravehicular activity, astronaut Ed White made the first American walk in space. Spurts of gas from White's handheld maneuvering device thrust him in the desired direction.
Are you ready, Captain?
The floating object in the foreground is the astronaut's overglove, left behind in the spacecraft.
I've exhausted the fuel now, but I was able to maneuver myself up front of the spacecraft back. Maneuver right up back on the back of the adapter. Took the box in, came back into his view. The only thing I wish is I had more.
Gemini provided more than 12 hours of experience in extravehicular activity. The training, the caution, the slow accumulation of facts paid off. Man can work in space. On all Gemini missions, a major objective was to develop re-entry flight path and landing control, so the spacecraft could land at a specific place on Earth. This required the development of new techniques for guiding and controlling the re-entry of the spacecraft. This is the view from the spacecraft window as Gemini re-entered the Earth's atmosphere. Glowing particles boiled off the protective heat shield to leave an incandescent wake. During Gemini, 10-man spacecraft made this fiery re-entry into the Earth's atmosphere. Gemini 12 was the last. Three of the manned Gemini missions were flown to investigate the problems of long-duration spaceflight. Gemini 4 was a 4-day mission. Gemini 5, 8 days. On Gemini 7, astronauts Lovell and Borman spent 2 weightless weeks in space. Flights confirmed the endurance of man and his new spacecraft systems. They showed that an astronaut can live in space longer than is required for a round trip to the moon, and thus paved the way for Project Apollo.